Hey everyone, Eric Auger here, real estate agent with America's Choice Realty, creator of the signature approach to sell homes. And today's topic is hanging on to the ledge. I just went to the pool with my daughter, Olivia Eugenie, who's downstairs listening. And interestingly, Eugenie has been taking a lot of swimming lessons. Probably like, I would say upward of 5 or 6 months of swimming lessons in the pool. And I've watched her at the pool jumping in the water and then swimming and not being afraid, hanging on to just a little like floaty things and kicking with her feet and doing really, really well. And I was really proud of her. But, and then water was no issue. You know, she didn't like her head underwater. That made her cry a lot. But then, you know, she got over it. And then something happened when we take her to the pool where she just does not want to swim. She will hang on to us or she'll just stay where it's safe, you know, where her feet are gonna touch the water, where she knows that there is absolutely no risk of her ending up underwater. And, or when she's in, you know, deeper water with us, she'll just hang on to us. We tried several times to just hold her hands or maybe hold her tummy, or we'll try different things to help her overcome the fear of the water, but nothing seems to be really working. And she's hanging on to my neck and she's just really happy the way it is. And there is just nothing I can do to get her to swim all by herself. And so something happened between, you know, the swimming lessons and the real swimming pool. And I suspect that what happened is back a few weeks ago, she slipped from the edge and she ended up her head underwater for a few seconds. And we just grabbed her and put her back on the ledge. And I think that this is the moment when she's learned that water was not just fun, but could also be scary. And that's the moment when she's decided, I am not doing that all by myself again. There's just no way. I will hang on to the ledge. I will hang on to my dad. I will go somewhere where I know I can touch the ground and it's safe, but I will not take a risk. And that made me think, you know, it is so much like my life and maybe yours, to where we've learned new things, new ways of looking at things, new ways of doing things. And then we tried and it didn't work. We ended up head underwater and somebody had to grab us and put us to the ledge. And then since that day, we've just been looking at the water without daring and going back into it. And it is such a limiting belief, such a strong limiting belief, that as much as we look at the water and as much as we want to go play in it, just like my daughter, I sure would love to go play in it, we just can't get ourselves to get off the ledge and get back in the water. And it's true in so many areas of life. It is true in relationships. It is true in business. It is true in how we take care of our body. It is true in how we take care of our spirituality. You know, the person who is not used to exercise and is going to go run as hard as he can for 20 minutes and he pushes so hard that the next day he just can't go back there. Or we try a new strategy in business, a new way of approaching things, and we crash and burn because it's the first time we do it and we expect it to shine. And so because we've learned that this is scary, we don't do it again. Or in relationship, you know, we do something, we say something that we thought was going to be so well received and we were excited about it, and it wasn't received at all the way we meant it. And so we kind of pull back because we're learning that being vulnerable in relationship is dangerous. Or even in spirituality, sometimes, you know, we do things and we put our faith in God, in our Creator. We do things and we crash and burn, and then we learn that God really doesn't care about us. None of that is true. What is true is that in order to learn something new, you have to accept that you're going to go underwater one time and maybe more before you can figure it out. And so my question to you is, where in your life, in your body, spirituality, relationship, or even business, where are you hanging on to the ledge and refusing to let go because you've learned that this was dangerous? And the second question is, how is that preventing you from getting what you really want? So that was my message for today. I hope that resonated with you. And I know it resonated with me. She taught me a lot today. She has no idea, but she taught me a lot. And I will see you in the next Facebook Live. Cheers.